Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times. And we're here today with Farmington Hills Mayor Vicki Barnett, who is running for re-election. How are you today?
I'm fine. And everybody, for your appreciation is my craft room background. So I apologize if it's a little messy. It's card making season.
No worries at all. Well, thank you for doing this. Can you tell us how long have you been mayor for?
I've been mayor for a year and a half, almost 2 years at this point, but I was also mayor in, sorry about that. I was also mayor in 2003 to 2007.
So in that time as mayor, what are some of the things that you're most proud of?
I'm proud of the way that we have maintained our AAA bond rating throughout all of these years, that the city council has always put the citizens and our business community first, and we have a great city council. Even when I wasn't on it, it was still a great city council. And that's what we're known for in this community, is making sure that everybody's voice is heard and that we really do things to make the citizens have the highest quality of life possible.
If you're reelected, what are some of the things that you'd like to work on?
Well, as I said before, we have a AAA bond rating, and we have maintained that through all of the ups and downs of the last 30 years. And as the economy changes, we've still been able to stay a very strong and vibrant city. And that's one of the things we have to work on. Over the last 10 years, through all of the different crises that have affected local communities, including the most recent, the pandemic, we have a lot of things going for us and a lot of things that have changed. For instance, our office buildings are not going to be used the same way they were before. So we have to find ways to reinvent ourselves, to attract young kids to our schools and families to move in, to take advantage of all the amenities we have to offer in this community. And that takes a new visioning process. And the last visioning was done in 2000 for 2020. Well, it's now 2021, so it's time to do a new visioning study, and that's what we're working on. We also have done something very exciting, and we have partnered with a private company to come in and build out our own broadband system throughout Farmington Hills. And that was a contractual negotiation that took quite a while to accomplish, but it's going to be built at no cost to our citizens, and they will be able to get high quality broadband and use the ISP provider of their choice. And that will help hopefully close the digital divide that exists, so that every student who's going to school and wants to, and people who want to work from home, have the advantage of having a robust internet connection that they can use. And we think that that's a real attractive drawing card to our community. We are also right now embarking on a build out of public art and using our older corridors to bring in our arts commission and talk about revitalizing those areas for the interest that art provides, the expression that art provides, and to really make our city very attractive to young people. We're also, in our building designs, when we have developers coming in, we're asking for different types of amenities. We want them to be built already wired for electric vehicles so that people don't have to pay for that later on. So there's, and we want apartments to have fire pits and outdoor amenities that people can enjoy. So we're looking more toward the future. Right now, we're not looking toward 2022, although we are, but we're also looking toward 2042. And so I'm very proud of the direction that this council is going and that we're leading the discussion along that way. I'm also very impressed with the census that came out. We are still one of the most diverse communities in the state, and we are welcoming to all races, creeds, religions. Our next challenge is, how do we make everybody feel comfortable? People with physical challenges, or people who are deaf and blind, people who have cognitive issues. How do we make our city vibrant for them as well? And so we are looking toward hiring a diversity, equity, and inclusion officer who will also look at those types of inclusive projects. Different types of playgrounds, different types of light switches along our roadways. How do we attract new businesses and minority-owned businesses to our community? So we are opening up at the Hawk. We bought the old Harrison High School, and we have just completed refurbishing it, as a community center and a business incubator. So I'm very excited about all of those options and opportunities that will be available to people going forward.
So can you tell us a bit about your professional experience and what skills you bring to the table?
Well, I'm a former financial advisor. I gave up my license when I went to the state legislature to serve for 6 years as the state representative. I started out my community activities way back when my kids were in elementary school. I consider the PTA the gateway drug to politics for a lot of us adults who really want to help our schools, and then we get drawn in and we want to focus on other issues in our community. So so that's how I started. Then I was elected to city council in 1995 and served for 8 years, then moved on to mayor, and then moved on to the state legislature, and now I'm back as mayor. So I have a lot of experience in municipal government, in municipal finance. I also served on the, when Governor Granholm was our governor, she appointed me to the State Boundary Commission. So I learned a lot about how communities can cooperate with one another without actually taking over one another. And I'm really using that experience a lot in our work with our partner city, the city of Farmington. We are a very close community and we consider ourselves one community. If you live in Farmington Hills, you consider Farmington your downtown. So we are constantly meeting together. We share a lot of boards and commissions, our library board, our park and rec commission, and the broadband commission that brought us a study to do broadband, which is going to be built out in both communities. And there's a lot of work that we do together, and that is invaluable experience. So I'm excited about that. I also served before it was the Department of Homeland Security, the Department of Justice formed a task force for interoperable public safety radio systems. And it was born out of the Oklahoma City bombing of the Murrah Federal Building. From there, our first meeting was going to be held in September 2011, sadly. I mean, 2001, sadly. And we quickly were scooped up into the Homeland Security Department to work on interoperable radio systems between police and fire agencies that respond. That has been a tremendous experience for me as well, because I was able to help out the build out of the Clemis system that we used in Oakland County years ago. And now it's being revamped, and we're still involved in those kinds of ongoing conversations. And as the anniversary of 2001, 9/11 approaches, or is even past when people are watching this, it's very important that we give our first responders all of the tools they need, not only to respond in real time to a crisis situation, but to also respond with an eye to keeping them as safe as possible so that they can continue to do their jobs. And it's been a great experience for me to watch these departments grow and the communication systems grow and grow with the needs of our public safety officers.
So in this race, you do have some competition for the seat. Why should the voters pick you?
They should pick me because I have the experience to continue to lead this city. And it takes experience when times are tough. It's not a walk in the park to be a mayor when we have a pandemic that is still raging, when we have office buildings that will not continue to be occupied at the rate that they were occupied before, when you need to bring the skills and the community together to revitalize those corridors and understand that work and life balance is going to change. And how do we protect the tax base along with those changes to make sure that the city maintains its AAA bond rating, that we continue to provide the high quality services that we're continuing to provide, and make sure that everybody can live their best life in the community. And I've been doing this for 30 some years already. And I look forward to 2 more years as mayor. If the citizens think that I've done a good job, I hope they reward me with their vote.
So if the residents want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
They can go to my Facebook page, which is Vicki Barnett. Whatever I post on there, I generally post on my mayoral Facebook page as well, and my website, which is electvicki.com. So I hope they'll tune in.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for doing the interview with us today.
Thank you so much for having me. And I really appreciate all the work you do. And it's a hard scramble to make sure that you're covering everything in Oakland County. And you do a wonderful job. And to all of your readers, continue to support Crystal and her work, and patronize White Castle. They're good.
Thank you. Thank you.